Welcome in to Getting Help from Uncle Sam. We have a wonderful guest here today, Candy Capel, who is going to be helping us with understanding the census and the importance of the census. And folks, you have got to fill that out. We're going to really give you some facts today, and stuff that I needed to know, even though I've done a million censuses as old as I am. But it's really important, Candy, and we're going to start out first with, you have to be sure that it's the right person who's either coming to your door or whatever, and what do we need to look for there?
Absolutely. So if you have a census taker come to your door, first of all, they should be wearing an ID that should identify them as a member of the Census Bureau. If you have any doubts, you actually can call the Census Bureau, and you can verify that this is a legitimate census taker. The other thing that we always want people to know is your Social Security number is never used for this process. So if someone calls you, emails you, comes to your door, says, I'm from the Census Bureau, I need your Social Security number to start the process, shut that down immediately.
Right there, you can close your door.
Right there, that's the end of that, because that is not a legitimate question.
Right, good. Okay, what is the census and why is it so important?
The simplest answer is the census is a population count. It is a count of everyone living in the United States at a certain point in time. So the census is only collected every 10 years. The last one would have been 2010, right now we're 2020, and so we are collecting population data. The reason that data is so important, there are two critical items. One is congressional representation. This is how congressional districts are decided, because when the data is delivered to Congress, that's how Congress is able to draw out our congressional districts. And if your population doesn't substantiate, or it tells you you don't deserve as many congressional districts as you have, then you will lose a congressional district. And that's what we're on the verge of. If you're imagining a cliff, we are on the cliff. We are going to lose a congressional district if our population does not justify having seven districts. And so when that's redrawn, who are we going to lose? Are we willing to lose one of our representatives? I don't think so. As you mentioned earlier, this is a critical time to have representation in Congress from Alabama.
Well, there are a lot of people who say, well, I really don't care if we have one extra congressman or not. Yes, you do care.
Yes, you do.
And here's why, because this is what the congressperson means. Talk to us a little bit about how that means money-wise to our state.
Absolutely. So that's the other half of the coin, is that the population also justifies our amount of federal funding. It informs Congress as to how much of that pie we deserve to receive. So if there's a federal pie of money that's allocated to states and cities like Montgomery, then if our share is supposed to be 10%, but our population says you don't have enough people to justify that, then you're only going to receive 6% this time. That's a huge cut. If you imagine, Virginia, every one of us, you and I, represents $1,600 in federal funding per year. Every person represents that, from one day old until there's no limit. So the money is important, because that money supports healthcare services like Medicare Part B and Medicaid. It supports our libraries, it supports our schools, whether those are after school programs or pre-K, Head Start. It's the reason that we can support our parks and also our roads and bridges. If you and I are out traveling on the roads throughout Alabama, we want to make sure the roads we're traveling on are safe and the bridges are safe. So federal funding supports all of those services, and if we don't receive our fair share, we're going to be short on money, and then that means we're going to be short on services. We cannot allow that to happen. Our high school students now, many are getting ready to return to school, whether it's virtually or in person. They're looking ahead to college. If they're planning to apply for a Pell Grant, that's where that money comes from. So the census equals representation, and the census equals funding, federal funding.
I think that, thank you, because you have tied this to what happens with each individual.
Every day.
And wow, if you stop and think about that, $1,600 in federal funds for each individual.
That's right.
That fills out that form.
That's right.
And no, it doesn't come directly to you. It does come indirectly to you, though, because it affects your schools.
That's right.
It affects your highways.
That's right.
It affects what libraries.
Parks,
it,
libraries.
Everything.
Everything that we do in our lives, in our daily lives. And again, especially our healthcare services. Look at how critical medical services are these days.
Amen.
In the midst of this COVID-19 pandemic. So certainly, and especially our elderly need our care. So we can't afford to lose money for Medicare Part B or Medicaid. That's we need to totally take that off of the table. And we can do that by completing our census.
Well, may I ask you this? If you tell us the best way to fill out that census form. I did it online. There are some people who might not be able to, but I think it took me 3 minutes. It's very fast.
It's very, very simple. I always tell people 5 to 10 minutes, 10 minutes tops, depending on how many people are in your household. Online, obviously, is the easiest way because it will guide you through every step. If you still have the form that was mailed to you, pick it up off the table and fill it out and mail it back. It doesn't even require a stamp because it's already postal paid. Or you can call. Now, there is a line that the Census Bureau has at 844-330-2020. But many times that line may be backed up. They can call the local census office and that number will ring to me. I can assist you with your census. We also have a spot set up in Eastdale Mall. It's called Census Central.
Okay.
We're there most weekday afternoons, and on Saturdays we have other partner groups come in and volunteer, and we help you do your census right there on site. So if you're out walking through the mall, because it's nice and cool in Eastdale Mall to take that walk, or you're out picking up something, or at the food court, you can stop by and we can help you. And as you said, it took you 3 minutes. I think it took me about 3 minutes also. It's very simple. The questions are very, very,
very
basic.
Easy.
It's your name, it's your date of birth, it's your race, and it's your address. And it's the same information for every person in the household. That's all that's asked. Nothing intrusive. It's very simple and basic information and easy to complete.
Well, Candy, thank you so very much. And please, all of you, fill in your census form. It means so much. And stay with us. We'll be right back.